time for our main event. One of the premier fighters of the last decade, Shane Mosley from nearby Pomona, taking on East LA native Sergio Mora. Mosley versus Mora is being brought to you by Cerveza Tecate con Carácter, Staples Center, the sports and entertainment center of the world, AT&T Viva Mexico plan. Make calls with your wireless phone to Mexico or from Mexico as if they were local calls. And by HBO Pay-Per-View, the best in pay-per-view entertainment, brought to you by HBO. Welcome back to Staples Center, where we're ready now for the main event. I'm Jim Lampley, along with Larry Merchant. Larry, Shane Mosley is much better known as a welterweight. Sergio Mora, by your description, is a natural middleweight. So, of course, they're fighting at the weight level between those two. Junior middleweight, 154 pounds. Let's take a look at the neighborhood, and you tell me what you think of it.
What most everyone thinks of it is that the non-champion in this division, Paul Williams, is the number one fighter. Miguel Cotto beat Yuri Foreman for a title at Yankee Stadium earlier this summer. Bundridge beat Spinks in an upset. Bundridge is trained by Emmanuel Stewart. And Zindurik is an undefeated Ukrainian who has impressed a lot of boxing people in Southern California, where he has trained.
And so now we take a look at two guys who may or may not have any aspirations in the division. Probably not. Probably they're just fighting each other at this weight level. Now, Larry, Shane Mosley, because of his overall quality and his Hall of Fame record, is a significant betting favorite over Sergio Mora. But there are many ringsiders and experts in the sport, including Mosley's trainer, Nassim Richardson, who will openly say that Mora might be just the wrong opponent at just the wrong time, given his height and boxing skills, the two qualities which have given Mosley trouble in the past. Why are we here?
Well, I think Sergio Mora put it as well as anybody. He says Shane Mosley is a warrior. Shane Mosley seeks out the toughest challenges. It's not the way I would go about it, Mora is saying. Shane Mosley is a different kind of fighter who has almost been self-managed, and maybe that's why he hasn't been maneuvered. He has maneuvered himself to where he is with his fists. But the kind of equation that he has with his opponent tonight, Mora, was the kind of equation sort of that he had in his last fight, and that didn't turn out too well, did it? Too well, did it? And what we have to understand is that at 39, with the right kind of opponent, you know, say Margarito, he can look 10 years younger. With the wrong kind of opponent, say Mayweather, he can look 10 years older. You got to give him credit for wanting to jump up on the bike again, Jim, and keep going. But sometimes the tires are flat and the gears wear out.
Yeah, you may want to question his judgment when I know at least a half dozen writers over there on Press Row, and they all know what they're talking about, who are openly picking Mora to win the fight. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for Sergio Mora against Shane Mosley. And you see the 9-year age advantage for Mora. When has Mosley had too much? 3-inch height advantage for Mora. Half-inch arm length advantage, measured from the armpit to the end of the fist. He blew the weight in at 157, eventually made it down to 154. Tonight, they've both gone up to 164. Let's go to Michael Buffer to begin the pageantry.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to honor the two fighters in our main event with their respective national anthems. First, here to sing the Mexican national anthem, Latina recording superstar, La Diva de la Banda, Jenny Rivera.
Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero aprestad y el bridor. Y retiemble en los centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiemble en su centro la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Ciño patria, tus sienes y oliva, de la paz el arcángel divino, que en el cielo tu eterno destino por el dedo de Dios escribió. Mas si osare un extraño enemigo profanar con su planta tu suelo, pienso, patria querida, que el cielo un soldado en cada hijo te dio, un soldado en cada hijo te dio. Mexicanos, al grito de guerra, el acero aprestad y el bridón, y retiemble en su centro la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiemble en su centro la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. ¡Viva México!
And now at this time, we would like to honor America, and especially our men and women now serving in harm's way around the world. And representing that group in the ring at this time, please welcome from the United States Marine Corps, a Purple Heart winner, Chief Warrant Officer Jared Murphy, representing all our wounded warriors and heroes around the world. And now, to sing our national anthem, please welcome to the center of the ring, Darrell Tank Babs.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free, and the home of the brave. Now or never, Army's finest.
Ladies and gentlemen, now coming to the ring, Sergio the Latin Snake Mora!
Warriors, come out to play! Warriors, come out to play!
Sergio Mora is 30 years old, never married, still single, no children. There is a kind of self-control about him. A guy who looks in the mirror and sees more than just a physical presence, but some kind of inner presence. And he spins it out in the ring, and sometimes he breaks away from it just with his emotions, as all of us do.
For many boxing fans, Larry, he has two identities. He's the guy who won the first season of The Contender. He's the guy who turned down $1 million to fight Jermaine Taylor for the middleweight title in Memphis in what seemed to be a no-lose situation. Because of that, many boxing fans and chatroom participants in particular immediately converted him from the Latin snake to the Latin fake. Can he eliminate the negative part of his reputation tonight?
Probably he can. Probably he's been the long-distance runner who wins the race if he achieves that. What he neglected to think about at that time was if he just makes a good showing, that would have elevated his status. But he didn't think that he was really ready as an athlete to take that on no matter what the money was.
Now making his entrance to the ring,
Sugar Shane Mosley.
We don't know if he's delusional or inspired, but he certainly is persistent.
Well, what was the second half of the Mayweather fight? Was that all Mayweather's brilliance and defensive skill? Or was that Shane Mosley at age 39 going off the diving board? That's been a part of the debate since May 1. He says, hey, it was just one fight.
Give Mayweather credit. He made that happen. He saw that he couldn't stand and punch with Shane in the early rounds, and he went back to being what he is as a boxer, and he controlled and dominated the rest of the fight.
Something that Shane has handled and responded to with dignity, the kind of dignity that has defined most of his career, not all. There have been slip-ups here and there, testing positive for performance-enhancing substances, something for which he has exhibited visible public shame. Boxing fans forgave him for that. Will they forgive him if he loses tonight? That remains to be seen. Let's go to Michael Buffer to follow up with the official introductions.
From the home of the world champion, Los Angeles Lakers, Staples Center, Los Angeles, California, USA. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, están listos. Are you ready for the main event of the evening? Presented by Golden Boy Promotions, 12 rounds of boxing in the middleweight division. Sponsored by Mexico 2010, Tecate, cerveza con carácter, DeWalt Tools, guaranteed tough, AT&T Viva Mexico plan. Make calls with your wireless phone to Mexico or from Mexico as if they were local calls. And Southwest Airlines. At Southwest, bags fly free. So grab your bag. It's on. Book now at southwest.com. This bout is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. Executive Officer George Dodd, Chairman John Frierson, Commissioners in Attendance Steve Alexander and Gene Hernandez. At ringside, the three judges scoring should it go the distance. Kermit Bayless, David Denkin, Dr. Lou Moret, and inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Pat Russell. And now, with dedication to a great friend of boxing, Dr. Frank Ryan, and for the thousands in attendance, and the millions watching around the world on HBO pay-per-view. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the red corner, wearing green with red, official weight, 157 pounds. His professional record, 22 victories, including 6 knockouts, only 1 defeat, with 1 bout even. From East L.A., California, the former junior middleweight world champion, Sergio the Latin Snake Mora. And fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white with red and green, officially weighing in at 154 pounds. His professional record, 46 victories, including 39 knockouts with 6 defeats. From Pomona, California, the former lightweight world champion, former 3-time welterweight world champion, and former junior middleweight champion of the world, Sugar Shane Mosley.
Okay, boys. Hang on a second. Let him clear the ring. Let him clear the ring. Take a breath. Let him clear. Michael. Second, fellas.
In the room with you. We gotta watch you. Jump through that head.
Buddy. I'll watch it. I'll be on it.
And let him grab it.
All right, gentlemen. We have a 12-round fight. Let me define this place for you. Right here. And right there, 12 rounds, touch him up, good luck. Come out at the bell. Thank you, sir.
The Los Angeles script is this. Mosley has the pedigree and the punch. Mora has the advantage in age and size and perhaps style. Roll him, Jim.
And the last pre-fight punch thrown by either side was trainer Nassim Richardson, Mosley's trainer, you heard him. Turning to the referee casually and saying, I want to mention one more time Sergio Mora's head and look out for headbutts. Mora, which Pat Jim, Russell was very casual. He said, sure.
Mora is wearing something below his right knee called a patella brace. We were unaware of that. Don't know if it means anything.
Patella, of course, is the tendon that attaches the kneecap to the shin bone, and maybe he stretched it or torn it or something like that, but we do not know. No prior information about that. And I'm glad you knew what it was, Larry. I thought maybe it was just decorative, to be totally honest with you. Well, you heard about Sergio Mora's movement, and so far, the first minute of the fight has been dominated by Sergio's movement, staying away. After a minute, he decides to engage and takes a good, solid left hook in the mouth from Shane Mosley. First significant landed punch of the fight.
You asked the question before, Jim, whether Mayweather's victory over Mosley was all Mayweather, or how much did Mosley contribute? It just strikes me, but we'll find out in this fight. See what Mosley can do against
Moore.
Because Moore is a live body.
Don't hit that kidney. Yeah. Don't hit that kidney. Stop.
And it's a style that gives Shane trouble.
Watch those kidneys, fellas.
But maybe Shane can simply chop him down as the sharper, stronger, more aggressive fighter. Maybe this time the height doesn't mean so much.
Watch your head.
So far in the first round, Mora has looked tentative, as though he's unwilling to engage. And Mosley, on the few advantages or occasions he's gotten close, has taken advantage. Scoring of the round, I think, would be dominated by the one big left hook that Mosley stuck into Mora's mouth. Mosley blocking Mora's right hand.
Stop the bell.
Well, if that was any indication, it's not going to be an action fight.
Sir, he's leaning back from your jab. When he keeps doing that, when he does that, throw a lot of the De La Hoya jabs. Jab, 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 and then catch him on the right.
I'm going to see if he's going to counter.
All right. He's trying to catch you with the left first and then the right. All right? He's trying to slip your jab and come up and over. All right? So, Serge, remember the rules. If he slips it over here, you will stay down that side. If you go like, if he goes like that, down that way, look at it this way.
If he said you're touching with it. He leans in, man. Just pop him quick with that jab. Don't wait on him, because he's going to hop in and just try to do some flashing. He's relaxing now because he's trying to measure you. Get that stick going, get that stick going so he can't tell the measurement.
Well, he's moving around a lot, so I can't really hit him with the stick yet because he's out of range.
You just got to let him sit. Don't have to. I keep telling you about trying to land it.
Just clear corner on it.
Well, in round one, Sergio Mora's style, such as it was, turned CompuBox numbers into a joke. Mora landing one of 30, one of 30, and Mosley 6 out of 22. Shane really could only get off 22 punches because Mora spent most of the round staying away.
Shane, let him go. Step back. You know, it's all right. Punch inside.
So far, we're getting the sparring match that Mora, as a young fighter, once almost had with Mosley when he was preparing for a fight.
Well, look.
All right, I got it. Stop.
Until moments ago when they started to engage. If this were a sparring session, most good trainers would stop it and say, wait, we need to work a lot harder than this.
One hit behind the head.
I wonder if Mora is showing more respect for Mosley, who he was a fan of, then he should.
The booing has begun. Those ringside experts, and I didn't think they were crazy, those ringside experts who were picking Mora to win the fight must be wondering when the guy they picked is going to show up.
Stop!
Because he's clearly not here yet. A minute to go in the second round. All Sergio Mora has really tried to do is stay away. There he turns southpaw and fires a body shot.
Let him go, both of you. Let him go, Sergio, let him go. Let him go, you got free hands. Stop, break, take a step, now go.
So Pat Russell discovers that telling the fighters to break isn't necessarily going to get it done. Right hand lands for Mosley. Mora just backing away. Turns southpaw again. Shane may get frustrated with the waiting, but it isn't going to be hard to win rounds this way. The booing picks up a little bit. Now Mosley manages to corner Mora and lands one punch before the taller, longer arm fighter ties him up. Mora can fight inside. And he got in one shot there before Mosley busted him back.
jab.
So he's gonna bend with activity. He's gonna BS with activity. That's why you gotta add a jab out there. He's gonna BS with activity. Shoot it sharp anyway. He dips, he'll dip into him. You can't just let him walk around and jump in when he's ready to. All right? Stop looking for one shot, even when you're jabbing. You see when you're jabbing, even when it's not landing, you're creating something, because he's still shaking off the cobweb. He ducking down and pulling away. So you create that right hand, come back with that up. All right?
On the inside, you gotta work a little harder than him with the one hand free. Right. Turn your legs around. You're not turning your legs around. Yeah, turn them around like that when you go in.
Together, they threw 55 punches in the second round. Mosley 7 of 29, Mora 4 of 26. The significance of that, a good junior welterweight should average about 55 thrown punches per round. One guy, not two. Harold, did you score those first two rounds, or did you not bother?
Okay, Jim, 2-0, 20-18, Sugar Shane Mosley. You know, Jim, the only thing I see that Sergio Mora is doing good so far is he feints real good. I mean, he gives you those feints constantly. You know, he sticks his head in, sticks his head back, flips his feet around a couple of times. But he don't punch hard. He just touches you. I mean, I haven't seen him throw a solid punch in two rounds. It's unbelievable. On the other hand, Shane Mosley, when he comes in, lands good, solid, hard shots. He's doing more damage. He's winning this fight on clean, effective punching. 2-0, Mosley.
You're a genius, Harold. Have you ever given anybody a round for good feinting?
No, never.
I didn't think so. Look at the chase. Look at Mosley running from one corner to another to try to get to Mora and land the punch. Mora tapping the back of his head as if to say to Pat Russell, can't you see what a foul-filled affair this is?
Right, watch your hands. Watch your head. Whoa. Sergio, watch that head.
I'm trying to figure out what Moore is trying to figure out. And I don't get it yet.
Free hands.
He's what I call one of those athletic ambush fighters who's looking to surprise you by jumping in and then wrestling you around in the middle of when he can.
Free up those hands. Stop.
It's an ugly style, but it's been effective for him in the past.
The king of the ambush style, Sergio Martinez, is sitting at ringside to our left. That's the Sergio who is right now a rising star in the sport and the champion of the middleweight division. Mora can't fight in his style.
Well, it's plain that what Mosley has decided that he can box with him and then take his shots when they come. He doesn't have to extend himself and expose himself, because Mora is more interested in not getting hit than in hitting.
Now, it's going well for Shane. You know, all he has to do is go through the motions to win the rounds, because Mora's not trying to win rounds yet.
Stop.
And Shane's actually landed a couple of fairly solid blows. And how about Shane playing up to the Mexican fans, Larry, with the word azucar, Spanish for sugar, on his trunks?
And wearing the Mexican flag colors.
Exactly right. Shane might have been thinking that because of Mora's style, Mexican fans would wind up rooting for him here.
Well,
in fact, I'm sure he's thinking that.
Well, Mora himself said people prefer cojones and heart over smart.
He's right.
I got it. Stop the bell. Listen. Break. Now listen. Listen to that bell. Time.
Now the boos are getting louder, as the crowd seems to realize what they're watching.
You're going to catch him with a four.
I know.
Take a deep breath. The jabs are doing a little bit better now. Cross it over, remember. See what he's trying to do when you jab? He's slipping this way. He's coming under. Don't go for that. As soon as he slips it, go the same way he slipped it.
Let your hands be when that round there. All right? But don't let him just fall back to the ropes and get out of there unscathed. When you go back to those ropes, you got to put that work in there and make them investments. You put him over here and you look for the head. He's going to start jumping around with his head. And touch him under there, man. Put that touch under there. We worked on this. But let that left hand back him up. When you start doubling your jab, that backs him to the ropes.
The last time Naz Richardson was in this building was the night of the Margarito fight, when he discovered that Margarito's gloves or wraps have been tampered with. Since then, Margarito has been going around saying I didn't know the gloves were loaded, but I promise I'll never do it again.
What's your take?
Free up those hands. Free them up, Shane.
As incidentally, Mosley landed a right hand in there.
Well, my take is a basketball player knows when a rim is a half inch off. Baseball player knows when a bat is a quarter of an ounce off. Football player knows when a football is a quarter of a pound off in pressure. How can a prize fighter not know that something's going on in his fist?
I could not be more in agreement.
Don't pull that head. Whoa, whoa, don't pull that head. Stop, stop.
Meanwhile, if we find something interesting to talk about related to the prize fight, which is taking place in front of you, we will certainly report it. It's becoming a wrestling match now, as Mosley has closed the distance between himself and Mora, and so rather than to simply try to stay away, Mora has begun holding Mora.
Don't put your head.
Mosley,
right, don't hit that kidney. Let's go.
Talking to Mora, telling
free
him to
up,
come
James.
On, come on, hoping that,
that
he'll try to make a better fight of it so
yeah.
that they can both function, and he thinks he can win that fight.
All right, I got to stop.
He's winning this
Watch
one.
Your heads. Now go.
You can almost hear Shane in there thinking, I gave you the opportunity. Didn't you want to do more with it than this?
Let him go, Sergio. Let him go. Let the head go. Let it go.
Mora has both of his gloves tightly fixed around Mosley's head as Shane bears in and tries to get something to the body. Hard right hand for Mosley. Left misses. Another right hand lands.
That right hand inside caught Mora's
right,
attention.
All right, you're holding yep. now. Step back.
He says, oh, now I'm in here with Shane Mosley.
Mostly Mora's just scratching and holding. But Mosley lands something good every once in a while.
Free hands. Free him up. Let him go. Watch your heads.
Well, if he said he
headbutt.
Didn't want to fight Taylor
I gotta cut.
For the long term, maybe he's not fighting in the early rounds. For the long term, but now
hard right hand by Mora. Maybe, best punch he's thrown in the fight.
Maybe that blood changed his mind.
Right, because he's bleeding from above the right eye and bleeding pretty profusely from
yeah.
an apparent accidental headbutt
whoa,
cut.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
and there won't
there.
Be a long term.
Don't pull that head. Don't suck it underneath.
If there's a short term.
Well, that blood, the cut from a headbutt, is the most exciting thing that's happened in the fight. Might create action.
Sir, what did you say about body shot?
That's right.
You did. You cut legs. Serge, you can walk in with the 1-2s now. Sergio, please step to the right. Remember you were catching all your sparring partners, you can step to the right with the right hand? That's what you gotta do. He tilts his head. Yeah.
Not bad.
Hey, he's used to fighting with blood. You know, this ain't no thing to him. Serge, you need to step. Your jab is roll it up.
Let's take a look at the headbutt, Larry. You know, they never look on camera in replay bad enough to cause the cuts that they cause.
But it can't, but you can see the blood.
You can see it starting.
Coming out of there. And it's in a bad place. Right below the eyebrow.
Exactly right. It's in a place where it's conceivable that it will bleed into the eye and affect his vision.
Maybe it will affect how he fights this fight, more importantly, at the moment.
We're into the fifth round.
Fighting southpaw.
No, standing southpaw. Please pardon the correction.
I stand corrected. In his later years, Mosley has often used the left hand primarily as a range finder rather than a serious punch to set everything else up. He's trying to use it more here, but it's difficult against a tall fighter who moves as much as Mora does.
Don't hit. Pick him up. You okay? Box.
This is pathetic. This is a pathetic performance in a big opportunity fight for Sergio Mora.
I'm thinking that if he wins the fight, if he happens to get the decision and comes on, it won't do him much good in the eyes of the fans with this kind of a stink-out fight.
Well, any judge who scores this fight for Mora
watch those hands.
Should be a candidate for lobotomy.
Well, it's not over. It's not to the halfway point yet. We don't know what's going to happen.
Punches up, Shane.
I'm trying to figure out why the crowd is excited.
They stood up for some reason. Ten seconds to go on the fifth round. And if Mora's performance was embarrassing before now, I think it was even worse in this round. The blood didn't do him any good at all in terms of competitiveness. And the boos are beginning to ring in Staples Center. And they're not booing Shane Mosley. He's trying as hard as he can to make combat. One of LA's most beloved figures, Irvin Magic Johnson, seated next to Oscar De La Hoya. A tremendous fan of boxing. In fact, Larry, I'll never forget. November of 1992, sitting next to you in Las Vegas. At the end of the 10th round of Riddick Bowe versus Evander Holyfield, one of the greatest rounds in heavyweight championship history, I caught Magic's eyes across the ring, and he looked at me and lifted his head back and simply shook it back and forth as though exhibiting blindism, but what he really was exhibiting was the ecstasy of watching a round like that.
You can bring your hands beat
and steal that round. And a positive cheer for Magic. We're looking for Magic here in the ring.
Round six begins. 12-round fight. Harold Letterman, how do you have it so far?
The excitement is killing me. 4-1. 49-46. Sugar Shane Mosley. Jim, I tell you, Sugar Shane Mosley, if anybody's right, doing any punching, it's Mosley. I don't know how long Pat Russell's going to let Sergio Mora just grab and hold. Let's talk about the cut for a moment. The cut was caused by an accidental headbutt. In this fight, we're using the California rules. The California rules say that at the start of the fourth round, we go to the scorecards on an accidental headbutt. So if that cut is made worse by legal blows, we would go to the scorecard to determine the winner. 4-1, Sugar Shane Mosley.
Harold, let's talk about the fourth round. You gave it to Mora. Was that because of the one cracking
the right
hand?
The right hand, yeah. I mean, why else? I mean,
the only good punch all night.
It was the only good punch of the fight.
Well, relative to the other rounds, it was a whirlwind. What makes this especially hard on the fans, and this is a big, enthusiastic crowd, upwards of maybe 13,000.
Right, don't hit those kidneys. Stop.
As they saw three sensational knockouts leading up to this. You don't want the warm-up act to be better than the big act.
No, it was almost a given, though, tonight with the Saul Alvarez versus Carlos Baldomir matchup. That if Alvarez was able to pull it off and knock out the sturdy Baldomir, he'd be the hero of the night. It was a setup.
Let the heads go.
And he did
Bring
it.
Up, Shane.
And if this fight continues this way, Alvarez may even get the newspaper headlines tomorrow. Oh, there's a good left hook. Momentarily clocked Mosley inside. Did Mora. And some of that comes from the fact that Shane has pretty much thrown caution to the wind to try to get something going here.
fighter has been the clear aggressor. Round by round by round. In a hard round to score, who are you going to give it to?
Pretty easy choice.
At this point, I think we can say without fear of contradiction that it was Mayweather who caused that one-sided defeat of Shane Mosley.
So you're saying that you think Shane looks alive, sharp, physically?
Well, against the type of fighter who's always given him problems before, a big guy who beat Vernon Forrest.
Sir, does he hit hard?
No.
Don't get stupid, though. Sergio,
you can land the right hand. Huh?
The same ones that Vernon Forrest landed.
What's the right hand? I don't want you to step.
Your right hand.
No round. It's seven. Going to get seven.
Yeah, seven. Seven. Seven coming up.
We're going to get a seven.
All right, here's an unusual sight.
Okay, Sergio, step to the right. Step to the right and jab.
Zigger is fine, Ben.
Here's that unusual sight. You see how Shane is dropping his hands, just thinking all offense, and Moura finally connects.
Yeah, he's landed one right and one left. They were both very good. But that was in six rounds.
Digging there. All right, it's time to start hitting this yoga with body shots, make it fair.
We're into the second half of the fight. CompuBox numbers, Mosley 54 out of 217. He's trying. Moura 24 out of 198. He's trying some of the time. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim. 59, 55, five rounds to one, Sugar Shane Mosley. It's the same thing round after round after round. Moura holding, Mosley trying to make the fight, landing whatever good punches are being landed. So certainly, based on clean punching, Sugar Shane Mosley 5-1.
Harold, send me a thank you note next week because I put you into an extra round. I gave you another appearance that wasn't even formatted for you.
Will do, Jim.
I love you, Harold. Your score reports are more exciting than anything that's going on in the rings.
All right, you guys,
some fighters you can't look good against. Moura may be one of them. But Mosley is winning the fight on aggression, but I can't say he's fighting an old-fashioned Mosley fight here.
Well, Shane's been in with guys you can't look good against. I mean, Winky Wright is exhibit A of a guy that you just don't expect to ever look good against.
And he lost the second fight, as I recall, by a split decision or a majority decision.
Moura landed another straight right hand.
Yeah. That's one of
those. Looks like when he leads with the right, instead of trying to 1-2, he surprises Shane. Shane's expecting to see him put the jab up first. Good little left hook inside by Moura.
All right,
he's coming alive.
Yeah.
Doesn't necessarily mean he wants to fight Moura. Yep. He's just doing better when Shane forces him to.
Shot in.
Good one. Left hook to the body. Another good body
right,
shot with the right hand.
Back. Watch your heads. Take a break. Now go.
Moura walked right into it. Well, it wasn't a great round, but it looks more like a fight than that which has come before.
And if he should get the round, he's still within distance of winning the fight.
Could be.
Towards you, go the right hand. Throw it at his bite, I don't care where. You did, brother.
You get that one?
How do you feel?
Good.
Yeah, he's not really landing anything, that's why. But you need to step to the right when you throw your right hand.
I got it.
You're missing it over his head. Throw it here, Serge, right here. Step that way, just like we worked on it. Throw it down at his chest. And he'll run right into it. And after you hit him, come back with the uppercut. Left uppercut. And finish your defense. How do you feel?
Good, man. Just gotta, you know, watch out.
Back to the ropes of the corner where you need him to be. Then you can double the jab, bend your knees, and come up with your shots. All right, bend your knees, take a quarter step, drive that right hand around. Come right back with the left foot. Come on, baby. Yo, the rounds are dead.
Sergio Mora landed 9 punches by CompuBox count in the 7th round, 9 out of 49. That makes it his best round of the fight statistically. Shane Mosley was 10 out of 35. We go to the 8th. And Harold gave the 7th to Mora. So if Sergio Mora were able to win this round, and you might describe him as being in the middle of a rally.
We see very few veteran fighters who fight with the same, let us say, enthusiasm and aggression in their later years as they did in their early years. And Mosley certainly isn't the fighter he was then. But here he is at the age of 39, still the aggressor, still going for it.
Step back, don't do that. Step back, box.
Like Archie Moore?
Like Archie Moore, like Lynn Johnson.
Free hands, free him up.
And when Shane is through fighting, whenever that is, he'll still be a gym rat. Training his son and other fighters, managing fighters. Boxing is Shane Mosley's life in every way. I think this has been a pretty big round for Shane so far. I haven't seen Mora do much of anything, and Shane has landed several good punches in reestablishing his aggression here in this round. It's almost as if Shane realized that he made the 7th round a little too easy for Mora and wants to take the win back out of his sails.
Fighting 3 minutes of every round.
Every second of the round. Shane Mosley. Well said, Larry.
Shane, we was in camp too long for this, man. Too long. We put the work in. The work was in there. I watch you do the work. You in shape. I watch you run. I know you're in great shape. Shane, ain't no excuses, baby. You're not performing what we worked on. All right? You corralling into the ropes perfect. And then you just letting him off the hook. Son, that ain't you. When you put him on them ropes, he got to pay a price for backing straight up on that line. If you keep letting him jump at you with them wild right hands, he going to land every once in a while. He going to get closer and closer. He was missing everything early, but he going to land one if you keep letting him throw. I need
that jab. No, I don't think so.
No, you're not losing.
Put that jab, put pressure on him.
This is our part right here that we wanted. Separate it now. Separate yourself now, sir. Use fast moves.
Moral with a word for you viewers at home. Meanwhile, how about the speech from Nassim Richardson to Shane Mosley? There's another guy who's still bringing it, right? Nassim's one of the great stories in the sport, having come back from a thoroughly debilitating stroke to almost 100% physical competence. Harold, how do you have this through eight?
Okay, Jim. 6 rounds to 2. 78, 74, Sugar Shane Mosley. You know, Jim, I got to tell you, Sugar Shane Mosley is the aggressor. Then the harder shots, the cleaner shots. But every time he gets Mora up on the ropes, Mora grabs him, and Pat Russell lets him get away with it. I just think that, you know, Mora's doing too much holding. I think that he should get at least a warning, if not a point deducted, because he's holding Shane Mosley constantly, and you're not allowed to do that. Pat Russell, just keep yelling, let him go. The truth of the matter is, Moore is holding him. It's almost like fighting an octopus. Be as it may, Shane Mosley certainly winning this fight of clean punches. 6-2 Mosley.
Yeah, I made the point very early in the fight that Moore wasn't going to break just because Pat yelled at him to do so. But there have not been many physical breaks by the referee.
And it's simply part of his...
All right, watch your heads, watch your heads, watch your heads. Step back.
His weaponry, right. If that's
headbutt,
what you can call it.
We're okay.
You know, fighting out of a pillbox. He's holding, grabbing, frustrating his opponent. That's what Mora does.
Second half of the fight has been better than the first. Maybe because of all his inactivity, Mora needed a little while to warm up. Get himself into the competition. I'm still not saying that he's winning it, but it's a little more competitive fight than it was for the first 4 or 5 rounds.
Let his head out. Don't hold the head.
Good block on the right hand by Mosley. Blocked it with his glove.
Those heads.
I have to give Mora's corner credit for keeping that cut under control. It has not become the factor in this fight that it might have.
Cut man is Carlos Vargas. He's done a good job on Sergio's eye. Body shots by Mosley. Shane fighting most of the time with his hands down. Unconcerned about
good left hook.
Any power from Mora. And it's an excellent left hook by Shane Mosley as he jumped in those last 10 seconds of the round.
Can you see? Get in here.
So you gotta let your hands move. You gotta take a step to the right. It'll give you a safe spot. All right? Let your fucking hands go. We're down the last 3 rounds. This is what we wanted. I know he's trying to be slippery and trying to run you into a shot, but you still got to
put it in. Stuff you hit me with, you're not going to hit him with it?
Yeah. These are 32s, right?
You can put him, son. Be in here.
Good. Okay.
Ref, we got to stop him jumping in with that head.
Sure, if you want to show it, I don't know
this
if we have the time.
This is the time we call on it, son. The work is in. You coming alive now because you're a great check. Dig down, put them shots in there for me. Double that shot up. Come on, my onion over. Double that shot.
I think it's too late now.
Go to that body like we worked on.
CompuBox numbers in 9. Mosley 18 out of 48. Mora 9 out of 49. The 18 connects in the round. Highest number so far for Shane Mosley in the fight. He's pulling away on Harold Letterman's scorecard. And despite what they told Sergio Mora in his corner, there are not 2 rounds remaining in the fight. There are 3. Unless Mora elects opt out after the 11th.
I got you.
All right, watch that head. Pick up those hands. Get those hands, let him go. Watch those heads.
Let's
go behind that head.
You see anything new, Larry?
No, I don't. I do sense that Mora may sense that he's got to turn it up.
Too late. I think he could win all the remaining rounds and it wouldn't make a difference is my guess, but we shall see. He is definitely putting forth more of an offensive effort in this round than has been the case before. Incidentally, this is the kind of fight Shane Mosley likes. Shane doesn't mind taking a few shots if it means he's going to get a chance to fire back.
Let that head go.
He's fighting the best fighters of his time. Mosley's been down in one fight by Ryan Charles.
Punches up. Stop. Break. Take a step.
Moore's landed a couple of good counter right hands in this round.
Frame up, Sergio. Frame up.
When you have so many listless rounds, if you do a little bit, you're going to get probably more credit. And he conceivably wins this round unless something else happens here.
All right, whoa, whoa, stop.
Good body work by Mosley there.
Box.
Mostly keeping Mora on the defensive.
Corner.
Biscuits, man. You're allowed to move.
No.
Somebody just told me on TV you're losing six rounds to three. But they're not the official judges. Okay? Take a deep breath. Serge, why don't you step to the right?
How's it feeling? Please. How's it looking?
Keep
Carlos?
Turning
not
and
bad.
Moving.
That's good.
Keep them into your jab and win this fight from
number 11.
For knowing something.
No, fucking move.
I don't get it.
I'm not saying you lost it, but if they're, what are they looking at? I don't know.
He's leaning and doing little yeah. Shit punches. Looks like he's busy.
Take it deeper.
All right. There's no way he wins these two rounds. I promise
okay.
You.
Wait a minute.
He can't keep jumping in and grabbing like that, Guerrero.
You heard Mora. Promises corner he'll win the last two rounds. He would need it to prop. Possibly squeeze something out of this. Does that mean he'll be more aggressive? And if he does, what'll that mean for Mosley?
Punches in the 10th round. Mosley 20 of 53, Mora 15 of 47. 10 of Mora's connects were power punches. That's his high water mark for the fight. When they told him that it was 6-3 in Mora's corner, on Harold's scorecard, they were wrong, of course. Harold's scorecard was 7-3, including that he gave Mora the 10th round. It was 7-2 prior to that. So numerically, at least on the Letterman card, which they accurately pointed out is unofficial, he would need a knockout, meaning Mora's.
As Richardson said, Mora couldn't knock the glass over with a running start. 6 knockouts in his career.
Couldn't knock a glass off the table with a running start. It's one of the better lines I've heard in a fighter meeting.
Don't push off, push back, go.
That replaces the time-honored couldn't crack an egg. Good right hand by Mosley. Mora couldn't duck under it.
Free him up, Shane. Watch those heads. Free him up. Let the head go. I got it. Stop. Get him out. Box. All right. Free him up. Free him up, Shane.
Mosley hanging on a little bit here.
Let him go, Sergio.
Shane's had to work to break the stranglehold of Mora's long arms. to create combat and a combat-free fight, at least for the first several rounds. Good right hand by Mosley there.
Well, Morris trying harder.
Yeah, Morris seems to have waked up in the last three or four rounds and realized it's a fight. And there's a clean right hand shot for Mosley.
Crowd getting what it wants now.
All right, I gotta stop.
They're trading now. Full on trades. Hard to say which man got the better of it, but Shane lands the heavier punches for sure.
He's hitting with those stupid punches over the top. Sergeant, are those punches hurting you at all?
No.
Okay, keep doing it. You gotta keep him at a distance. You're not going to step two, man. I'm telling you, that's a big one. Talk around, baby. Let it all hang out. Let it all hang out.
Brown, he's gonna hold and headbutt
both arms. I know, I got you, coach. But we're both working inside, and they're freeing him up when they do it. So
my guy gotta hold him because he don't wanna get knocked down. This guy diving in. Shane, ref ain't gonna be there for it. They're gonna let this guy hold. You got a middleweight laying on you, Shane. Is that grease running for me, Jim?
Yeah.
Dennis. Over there.
Oh, got it. All right. Dennis. Baby, this is it right here, baby. Come on, baby. Everything you got, baby. Everything you got.
Thank you for a good fight.
Well, the 11th round is clearly the best round of the fight. Mosley is 20 of 41 by CompuBox count. Mora, 20 of 68. Shane with a 50 punch, connected punch advantage. Entering the final round, Harold, how do you have it through 11?
Okay, Jim, 107, 102, 8-3, Sugar, Shane Mosley. You know, Jim, I agree with Nassim Richardson, who yelled at Pat Russell at the end of rounds 10 and 11. He's holding. But, you know, obviously, Pat Russell said to Nassim Richardson, I ain't doing nothing about it. That's all there is to it. I don't know why Pat wants to keep pulling him apart, but he lets Mora get away with all that holding. Be as it may, Shane Mosley, the aggressor, landed the cleaner, harder shots, winning the majority of these rounds. It would be a shame to give this fight to Sergio Mora. You know, doing all that holding.
Look at Mosley. Let him go, Sergio. Let
Good him go. Call, Harold. I agree with you. And look at Shane working down the stretch. He just never quits, Larry. Competitor, competitor, competitor.
You know, he's like a star actor. Movie actor who occasionally gets into a clunker, but everybody loves him for the body of his work.
Tonight, it was the smaller body, the shorter body, but by far the harder working body. He has made more of a fight. Not all that easy to do. Right there. Right now, Shane is letting his Los Angeles fans know that he would like to close the show, even if he's not likely to get a shot while being held along the ropes.
You can hear him grunting all over the ring.
All right, I got to stop punching. Step out. Shane, take a step. Box.
Shane Mosley has accomplished something very noteworthy in the last five or six rounds of this fight.
Get those hands. Let him go, Sergio.
He forced Sergio Mora to fight honorably. He shamed him into a real fight. You gotta love that. Go, Shane. Keep it up.
Watch those hands.
How can you not root for that man? After everything he's done for the sport.
Stop! Take a step.
Just never quits.
If he collapses, it'll be at the finish line. After giving
those hands. Let him go.
Every ounce of himself for every minute of
Watch
this fight.
There isn't a boxing fan alive who's ever been shorted on a live ticket or a pay-per-view by this man. Shane Mosley is always worth the money.
And they hug once again after the fight.
Just to cap it off. An evening of embrace. It'll be the 47th win of Mosley's brilliant career against the six losses if, in fact, the decision goes the way we expect it to. Final round CompuBox numbers, Mosley 29 out of 75, Moore 11 of 63. You see that Harold Lederman has it 117, 111, 9 rounds to 3 for Sugar Shane. This is not a particularly experienced judging panel. Kermit Bayless, you know his twin brother Kenny Bayless as a very prominent referee in Nevada. David Dinkin, one title fight. His father is a very prominent, well-known judge and referee here in California, Lou Moret. The most experienced judge by far on this panel had Corrales leading by three before he was knocked out by Jose Luis Castillo in their amazing first fight. Larry Merchant has left ringside. Hugo into the ring. Michael Buffer is still awaiting the official decision balance. Mora looking for, at age 31, soon to be 31, looking for the 23rd victory of his career against the one loss to Vernon Forrest and one draw.
Number liquidators, the Walt, the Cate, thank you everyone, thank you Golden Boy.
Way to go, Sergio. Thank those sponsors. They'll appreciate it. Fans may not be thrilled. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at Staples Center, we go to the scorecards. Kermit Bayless scores the bout 115-113 for Mora. David Dinkin scores it 116-112 for Mosley. Dr. Lou Moret scores the bout 114-114, a three-way split. This bout officially is a draw.
Atrocious. Absolutely atrocious. A joke, a travesty, an injustice. A terrible decision. Horrible. Harold, what happened?
Jim, I agree 100%. But I've been here 2 days, I've been to two fight cards, and I'm telling you, the officiating here leaves a lot to be desired. There was a preliminary tonight with David Rodella. He got a draw in a fight that he clearly won. Jose Navarro last night on a Telefutura show, they gave him one round out of eight when he clearly won three or four. The officiating here is just absolutely horrible. They got to do something about it. This is just another example.
Kermit Bayless scored this 115-113 for Mora. He needs more schooling. Lou Moret has been around a long time and scored it a draw. He should know better. Final CompuBox numbers show Mosley landing 68 more punches, an average of about a half dozen per round. Throwing 14 more punches, Mora threw a lot of punches down the stretch trying to catch up. Power punches virtually doubles Mora's connections. Throws 45 more power punches, lands at a 14% higher connect percentage. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight was not a draw. This decision sucks. Here's Larry Merchant with Shane Mosley and Sergio Mora.
Thank you, Jim. Shane, did you think you'd won the fight?
You know what? I mean, Sergio fought a hard fight. You know, I thought maybe I could win my way, but a draw, we both fought hard, so what do you say?
Come on, Shane. You were the aggressor for 35 of the 36 minutes of this fight, and you're satisfied with a draw?
Well, you know, I think that it was a good fight. I mean, Sergio is not a big puncher, so he had to box. That's his main thing, to box, move around, stuff like that. And I knew what my job was, so it was hard to get him. I knew he was moving pretty fast, but what do you say, you know?
You were hoping that this would relaunch you into a major fight. Do you think, based on this fight and outcome, that you can still attract a major opponent?
I think so. This is a different type of fight. I mean, this man right here is a middleweight, and he's coming down to, you know, the 54, and he moved very well. He kept me away, he kept me at distance, and you know, I mean, it would probably be a different fight with somebody my size, my weight. I think we're getting more of a slugfest, if you will.
Thank you, Shane. Sergio, did you think you had won the fight?
First of all, I want to thank God for all the strength he given me. But yes, I thought I won the fight. I thought I did enough to win this decision, but I respected the man way too much. I mean, that's Sugar Shane Mosley, a legend, and he's a great guy. You know, with Vernon Forrest, God rest his soul, but I wanted to hurt him. And with Shane, it's just, you know, I want to win, but I respect him so much, and I thought I won the fight, though, Larry.
Your own corner was telling you that you were so far behind that you probably needed to do something special to win the fight. You didn't believe them?
No, I didn't believe them. And that's something, I mean, I felt I won this fight. I felt I won this fight about at least two rounds. I should have listened.
What do you feel this fight and the way you fought has done for your career?
Well, I think that if going 24 rounds with Vernon Forrest and 12 rounds with Shane Mosley, two Hall of Famers, I mean, that says it in itself. You know, I have two legends in my Hall of Fame resume. So, I don't know. We'll see how the judges and the critics see this, but I thought I won the fight.
Thank you very much. Jim?
Wow. All right, so the real injustice here, at least as far as I'm concerned, is that Shane Mosley was looking for another big fight, possibly a fight with Manny Pacquiao, possibly a rematch with Miguel Cotto, maybe a fight with unbeaten welterweight Andre Berto. And if the decision in this fight, a draw, in some way affects Shane's ambitions and limits his chance to get another fight like that, that would be what you call a crying shame. But at the end of the day, it happens, and in a state, frankly, which has been called into question for officiating and other practices here in the past, there is once again a giant cloud over this particular decision and this fight. Agreed?
I would say the only ones who stunk more than Mora were the judges. I have no desire to see Mora fight again. I respect all fighters. They go in, they do the best they can. Hopefully they get in top shape, give their best effort. But to me, what he did was not professional fighting, and it's something I don't have to see. I hope, I wish him the best luck in the future, but, and that's his decision. My decision will be, I hope I'm someplace else.
If the draw prevents Shane Mosley from getting another significant fight against a Pacquiao or a Cotto rematch or a Berto, that's an unconscionable injustice, isn't it?
I think it is, but I think if he'd have won a decision, split decision, real decision, he's still Mosley. He showed that he's still willing to fight for 12 rounds. And if one of those fighters needs an opponent who has one of the best resumes in boxing, they'll reach out to Shane Mosley. I want to go somewhere else with this, Jim, which is, this was an amazing scene here tonight and this weekend. And with the crowd last night here in Los Angeles, where they were celebrating the 200th bicentennial of Mexican independence, Golden Boy put on a terrific show, including a prize fight that was on Televisura, a card, plus bringing back many old-time fighters to sign autographs, plus booths. It was like a fair. And they generated this crowd, and by connecting themselves and the great Mexican and Mexican-American heritage that is being built up about boxing. And that's what really, to me, this night was about. I'm going to look at the first three fights and remember them, and this fight will be filed away in some deep recession in my brain that I hope can't remember it in about 24 hours.
So that's it. A really well done promotion, a great weekend of boxing in Los Angeles, marred only by a horrid decision in the main event. All right, Larry, thanks very much. Once again, Shane Mosley clearly beats Sergio Mora and does not get the decision as judges somehow rule it a draw. We ask you, boxing fans, for the sake of Mosley and the sport, ignore the official result. This was not a draw. This was a victory for Shane Mosley. Let's see what happens from this point forward. Mosley versus Mora has been brought to you by Staples Center, the sports and entertainment center of the world. Cerveza Tecate, con carácter. DeWalt, guaranteed tough. AT&T Viva Mexico plan. Make calls with your wireless phone to Mexico or from Mexico as if they were local calls. And by HBO Pay-Per-View, the best in pay-per-view entertainment, brought to you by HBO. We'd also like to thank the following internet partners. Plus, you can get exclusive updates from HBO's Facebook and Twitter sites, and as always, at HBO.com, the online home of HBO Boxing. Now for our entire crew, I'm Jim Lampley saying so long from Los Angeles, California.